Hi again! Things are moving fast and we are now in the third and last tutorial of the series, building the user interface for a shop application. Okay, let's open framework map one more time. We have already modeled the entities, written the business logic, the database is created and we have also loaded some data, and the server is up and running. Our last step is to create a WPF user interface to deal with the entities. Okay, we close this. We are going to reload SOAP Windows and let's see if it compiles now. Oops, my entity again. Let's comment this out, start SOAP Windows and hit F5. Here it is, we have the application now. Just a menu doing nothing. Cool. The main task using Signum Windows is write the user controls. Let's open my entity for an example. We define user controls for our entities, not Windows, because they are more declarative and composable. We write our controls using plain SAML and a very handy user controls like value line defined in Signum Windows. Also, we added a thin layer over WPF data binding, like this common type context thing and this common route. Standard data binding still is more flexible, but this syntax is simpler when using entities and gives us extra information. We have worked hard to make this SAML code as short as possible. But also, we help you writing the user controls with a little bit of code generation using a template. Add new item, Signum entity control, and the first time you have to pick your entity assembly. New company, okay, yes. And we follow the same process for all the rest of the entities. So, new item, not for a customer because it's abstract, but for an employee, an order, a person, and a product. For all the simple entities, just a stack panel with some value lines have been created. But in the order, because it has an mlist with embedded entities, we have a more complex layout with an entity list, a data border, and look these two entity lines. Let's make the first one an entity combo. Okay, we make this a bit wider, and let's go to design view. Here we have the four value lines, the master detail view for order lines, the entity combo, and the entity line. Also, we have to tell the navigation manager which is the default control for each entity type. So we remove this, and for company, the end is company. We copy this, and for employee, the end is employee, and for order, person, and products. Okay, also, we can make these entities not that easy to create by changing this isSimple type flag to true. Okay, we can arrange this a bit and remove the nodes, we comment this out, F5 and, oops, a problem in the menu, okay, let's do it now. It's gonna have three menu items, one is admin, customers, and orders. Orders have find and new. Customers have companies and people, and admin has employees and products. Let's make employee admin options instead, and we hit F5. Oops, we have a problem. We're lucky all this is compile time checked. Try again, and now it works. We have the menu here, and let's see the admin page for employees. Look, it's fully working with the three employees we have. You can resize it. And validations are working okay. And let's create a new employee. It's going to be Tom Hanks. Okay. We can save this. Let's try another option like orders find, and oops, we have an exception. This is because we haven't created any query in the query manager. So let's go to the server, queries, and we can comment this out. A product has name and price. We copy this. A company has company name, email address, and phone. Same for employee, but with first and last name. And for the orders, we can use lazy straight on the query. Too lazy. This is a very convenient feature. Let's see, companies. And here we have a search window with all the companies loaded in the database.
We open one and this is a normal window, just a placeholder for your entity control.
And we are using the company control that have been automatically generated. As you see, validation works properly. And also it provides you with three buttons, reload for getting the new entity, save to save the current entity, and close just to close the form and make no change. So let's do that. Back in the search window, it also provides you a filter panel. Let's find the companies with Hall in the company name. Here it is.
Let's go to orders now. We have none, so let's create a new one. And look how many things we have for free already. Daytime pickers, a combo of states, a master detail view of order lines with entity lines with auto completion. All this is cool, but probably it's not exactly what we want. So let's see how to modify it. We go to order XAML.
Group of process with value lines. This goes down, this is redundantly. Group buffs of customers. This goes up, a stack panel, another stack panel, a border, and format all.
Graph of products, this goes down. A doc panel here. Grid with two columns, these two go up. Remove this, this goes to the left, this goes to the right. Not read-only, a dog panel here, top, down, no labels, left, right, and let's see the design view. Let's see, it's okay now, maybe some margins here, here, and here, and here. Now it looks better, just some events that I context change here, and entity line creating here. Okay, let's go to the code behind and var product is a lazy of product navigator find a new product and search and load equals true if the product is null return null, otherwise a new order line with this product we have to retrieve it and quantity is 1. Okay, let's add a proper to a string to order line, so override toString is formato quantity product. Okay, and for product as well. Okay, we save this and turn back. And for the border child is when it's a person at the end, a person. When it's a company, and otherwise just null. Let's make orders user control a windows instead, so we get rid of the normal window buttons like save and we place our own. So dock panel button, stack panel to the right, horizontal, first button for the order. We copy this, paste it, and error summary to show the errors. Data context change, and click, click, and click. Change the content, paste and ship, and let's go to the code behind. Here we are going to create a new property, order DN my order. In the get, we are just going to cast the data context, and in the test, we have to assign null first to force the change. This is a bit hack. Data context change, order is new value, if it's null return, set is read-only, and enable the buttons properly. Then let's bin each button with the web service we created in the last tutorial. Let's try. Oops, we have a problem. Create and modify order doesn't return anything. Let's change it. We go there, order, try again, we have to implement it in the server, so order, return, return, and let's go to the logic, order, and order, also let's create a new calculate total price method in order.dn. We create it, and total price is going to be sum of quantity times price of the product. Okay, let's go back to the client and in Navigation Manager, we have to change view to view window for an order at the end because order is a window now. Finally, let's add some last validators to order line, not null validator, and that's all. Thank you for listening. Signum Toys, how can I help you? Hey Bill, how you doing? We're doing fine here in Spain, you know, Sunny. So, what do you need?
Lego
Mobile Command Center. How many? Oh my god, 20. What are you going to build, man? It's okay. That's it?
Yeah.
It will be about $1,800. You can pay in installments if you want. Okay, it's pay now. See you soon then. Take care of Melinda and enjoy the building.